The 1960s. Civil unrest. Free love. Cold War. Britain's secret weapon in this dangerous time? A fashion photographer by day and international spy by night. His name? Austin Powers. Placed in cryogenic storage in 1967, he's back to fight his evil nemesis and, above all, to party.
Yeah, baby.
Suck it to me.
Fuck it to me.
Suck it to me, baby.
It's Austin Powers, electric, psychedelic, pussycat swingers club. And now, here's Austin.
So he says, wrecked him, almost killed him. Oh, excuse me. I didn't see you come in. Allow myself to introduce myself. My name is Austin Powers, and this is my shagadelic swinging shindig, baby. Do you like the groove? Do you? Let's do it, baby.
Groovy, baby.
Well, as you know, I've been frozen since 1967, and a lot's happened since then. You might think that I'm out of date, but as long as people are still having promiscuous sex with many anonymous partners while experimenting with mind-expanding substances in a consequence-free environment, I'll be sound as a pound, man. Yeah!
Did he say what I thought he said?
Did she say what he thinks she thought?
Did he say what she thinks he thought?
Now, the reason I'm throwing this swinging shindig is to celebrate the release of my new film, excuse me, darlings, Austin Powers, International Man of Mystery. It comes out May 2nd and stars myself and the beautiful Miss Elizabeth Hurley. Did that make you horny, baby? Yeah.
Yes, that makes me horny.
She's a very groovy bird, man, very switched on. And you know what? This is my happening, baby, and it freaks me out! Yeah, baby! Let's look at a clip from my new movie, Austin Powers, International Man of Mystery. Come on, babies, let's go!
Danger Powers, personal effects.
Actually, my name is Austin Powers.
It says here, name Danger Powers.
No. Danger's my middle name.
Okay, Austin Danger Powers. One blue crushed velvet suit.
Hey, all right.
One silver medallion with male symbol. One Swedish made penis enlarger pump.
That's not mine.
One credit card receipt for Swedish made penis enlarger, signed by Austin Powers.
I'm telling you, baby, that's not mine.
One warranty card for Swedish made penis enlarger pump, filled out by Austin Powers.
I don't even know what this is. This sort of thing ain't my bag, baby.
One book, Swedish made penis enlarger pumps and me. This sort of thing is my bag, baby, by Austin Powers.
Ah.
Whoopia Kojo.
You know, one of the things I love about the 90s is all the fabulous new music. Here's Beck with the new Pollution.
She's got a cigarette on each arm. She's got the lily white cat equations. She's got a carburetor tied to the moon. Pink eyes looking to the fruit of the ages. She's alone in the new pollution. She's alone in the new pollution.
Mr. Powers?
Please, baby, don't call me Mr. Powers. Call me Mr. Higginbottom. I don't know why. I just like that name.
Would you like to have a quickie?
Oh, behave. Aren't you the cheeky one?
Not that kind of quickie, silly.
This kind. If Bjork and Beck had a child, would it be named Bjork?
If Cher's ex-husband called John Lennon's widow in Italy, Would it be Sonny Bono, Telefono, Yoko Ono?
Who writes this stuff anyway?
If U2's lead singer did free legal work, would it be Bono Pro Bono?
In order to fully grasp the humor of the last item, you must know that the Irish rock and roll band U2 is led by a gentleman named Bono. Also, you need to be familiar with certain terms used in the legal profession. Trial work done for free is known as pro bono work, pro bono being Latin for as a gift. Thus, the joke concludes with the witticism, Bono Pro Bono.
Какой придурок!
Oh, thanks, baby.
Yeah. She's got a paradise camouflage, like a whip crack sending me shivers. She's a pole in a strip mine ocean, riding low on the drunken rivers.
The Austin Powers Sexy Dictionary defines an Eskimo hooker as a frosty frosty.
I'm curious, do you use a dictaphone?
Can you say that on MTV?
Oh, hey.
She's a lonely revolution. She's a
Iceland's number one singer had a baby with Sweden's number one tennis player. Would the baby be called Bjorn Bjork Borg?
You see, Iceland's most popular export, besides bauxite, of course, is the pop star Bjork. In the 70s, tennis was dominated by the powerful Swede Bjorn Borg. Thus, who cares?
Sorry. Now, if that baby was adopted by the star of Logan's Run, would the baby be Bjorn Bjork Borg York?
Leave me out of this.
This is cruel and unusual. Look, I'm cross-eyed.
Don't have a rambo.
She's a lonely.
The Beck stops here.
You know, the key to being a shag magnet like me is this. You've got to use second words, baby.
Trombone.
Sexy, baby.
Princess Leia.
Very sexy.
Juicy navel oranges.
Very, very sexy.
Volvo.
Stop or I have a thrombone.
Tetherball.
Very sexy, baby, yeah!
Juicy navel oranges, mmm.
Lesions.
I'm sorry, but what's sexy about that?
In the afterlife, you could be headed for the serious strike. Now you make the scene all day, but tomorrow they'll be held to pay.
Baby, the party's just getting started. When we come back, all these birds are gonna get naked and covered in baby oil. We're gonna have a big orgy. Or not, you know, it could go either way, really. Don't go away. More shagadelic nonsense ahead. Yeah, baby.
I'm shag mad, baby.
Allow myself to introduce myself. My name is Richie Cunningham, and this is my wife, Oprah. Oh, I feel a bit bummy. Well, welcome back to Austin Powers Electric Psychedelic Pussycat Swingers Club, hosted by yours truly, Austin Danger Powers. It's a very happening shindig, baby. We're all having a groovy time.
Knackwurst.
Sorry, we're all out.
You keep saying you got something for me. Something you call love, but confess. You've been a messin' where you shouldn't have been a messin'.
I'm like totally digging these 60 tunes, but how do we dance to them?
Well, I'll show you. Come on, guys, let's go.
You keep lying when you ought to be truthin'. And you keep losing when you ought to not bet. You keep saying when you ought to be a changin'. Now what's right is right, but you ain't been right yet. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. You keep playing where you shouldn't be playing. And you keep thinking that you'll never get burned. Ha! I just found me a brand new box of matches, yeah. And what he knows you ain't had time to learn. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. That's why.
Austin, you think you can play something a little more current?
Sure, baby, I'm with it. Come on, let's go. Switch it on, baby, yeah!
I'm the fear addicted, danger illustrated. I'm a fire starter, twisted fire starter. You're the fire starter, twisted fire starter. I'm a fire starter, twisted fire starter. Yeah. On the plate you're tasting, fell intoxicated. I'm a fire starter, twisted fire starter.
Oh yes, much better. Yeah, baby, yeah! Complex. We have a square in the complex. Hold on. We have a square. It could ruin the party. We have a square, and here he is. Yes.
No, 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 no. I'm not a square. I can groove.
No, no.
Shagga, 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 shagga.
It's shagadelic, baby. Okay. You know, the first step to getting better is to admit that you've got a problem.
Okay.
You're a square.
Square.
You're a square.
Square.
You're a square.
Square.
Okay, Bruce, can we help this man out, can we? Thank you. We need to get him all swingified. He'll make you a swinger in no time, baby. Yeah! Okay, that was close.
Woo! How do you know if you're square?
It's not like you can just pee in a cup and wait for the results. Did I say something dirty, didn't I?
Can I take your temperature?
I think I might have said something dirty. All right, now pull out your pen. So?
You've got one behind your ear.
And prepare to take the swingers quiz, okay? You're right. Question number one. How many times a week, on average, do you shag? A, 10. Come on, lad, do it for England. No points. B, 30. Good on you. 5 points. C, Wilt Chamberlain. Hello, hello. 10 full points. Question number two. Are you a member of the Mile High Club? A, yes. If you see this jet of rocket, don't come a knocking, baby. That's good for 10 points. B, no. Well, this time yet, man. Have faith, okay? If you build it, they will come. Behold. Okay, no points. And C, what's the Mile High Club? Sorry, minus 5 points. Okay, this next question is slightly personal. Do you masturbate? A, yes. Thank you for being honest, baby. 5 points. B, no. Bloody liar. 5 points to you as well. Question four. Are you a Swedish stewardess? Give yourself 5,700 points if you answered yes. Swedish birds and stewardesses love to shag mad. They're shag mad, baby.
I'm shag mad, baby.
Well, that's the end of the quiz. If you kept a tally of your points, shame on you. You could have spent that time shagging, baby, or at least thinking about shagging, or, you know, preparing to shag. I'm sorry, but you're obviously not a swinger, because tests are for squares, baby. Remember my credo. I shag, therefore I swing. Okay, great. Hey, you look great, baby.
I feel better.
Well, you look fabulous, smashing, baby. Come on, let's groove, babies. Let's do it.
Austin, I want to show you something.
We're going to outfit you with this. It looks like a watch, but in fact, it's a geosynchronous positioning device.
Very shagadelic.
And then there's this.
Okay, let me guess. The floss is garrote wire, the toothpaste is plastic explosives, and the toothbrush is the detonation device.
No, actually. Well, since you've been frozen, there have been fabulous advances in the field of dentistry.
What do you mean?
Krakatoa. Shuck.
Krakatoa.
Sorry?
Krakatoa? It doesn't mean anything?
Krakatoa.
After I was unfrozen, the boys thought I might have some problems with the old noggin. So they gave me a test. And the head shrinker says, what do you see? Well, I see two birds. And the doc says, what kind of birds do you see? Robins, swallows? And I said, well, I don't know, but I can tell you that these birds are Swedish. Yes, and they're wearing uniforms of some sort. That's it. They're Swedish stewardesses, baby.
Bring on the sexy stews, man. Yeah.
Yes. So he shows me this. And so I say, what's your bloody idea? Show me the exact same picture. You know as well as I that these are the same two Swedish stews.
We're called flight attendants now.
And look, they're fond of each other. Quite fond. Oh, my. Very naughty girls. Very naughty indeed.
Oh, Austin, behave!
Not even you can see something sexual in this, Mr. Powers. I look at it and I go, of course I can, baby. It's two groovy polar bears shagging in a snowstorm. I had no idea that psychology was so erotic, man. Just look at that! Does that make you horny? Does it? It makes me very randy indeed. Now, surely, when you look at this, the shape of it, it makes you horny, right? Does that make you horny, the shape of it? Does it? My bits and pieces are tingling, baby, yeah.
What's wrong with that guy?
Now, this doesn't do a thing for me. Odd, isn't it? I don't feel a bloody thing down below. Just kidding. This makes me extremely horny. Should make a dead man pop up from his coffin and say, I'm very horny. Don't bury me yet, mate. I'm still very randy. Yeah. Well, cool, blimey, now you've done it. It's the Grand Tetons, baby. Does that make you horny? Do you have blood in your body? Do you? Do you have a heart that beats like I do?
I
have a headache.
Warning! Horny swinger on the loose, baby! In addition to being an international man of mystery and a full-time swinger, I have a band called Ming Tea. Well, we're more of a collective than a band, really. Well, we're practically a utopian society. Anyways, here's our new song, BBC!
Mrs. Will ya make me tea? Make love to me. Put on the telly. To the BBC. To the BBC. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
BBC One.
Mrs. William, make me tea, make love to me, put on the telly,
to the BBC, to the BBC.
What's purple and hums?
An electric grape, baby.
Hey, that's it. Let's go. You stole that last line from Laughing.
Last night I had German Chinese food. An hour later, you're hungry. For power.
What did you say?
This is William. Let me take my love to me. Put on the telly.
To the BBC. To the BBC. Yeah, yeah, yeah. BBC One. BBC Two. BBC Three. BBC Four. BBC Five. BBC Six. BBC Seven. BBC Heaven.
BBC Peace. Woo! Thank you. Thank you very much. We'll be doing a stadium tour this summer on a triple bill with House of Pain, Slayer, and Ted Nugent.
Groovy. Groovy.
Why don't you enjoy a clip from the movie while I catch my breath, you cheeky devil?
Yeah, baby.
I don't want to sound paranoid, but I've had some bad relationships in the past, and I have been known to be jealous. I'm sorry.
No, don't be sorry, baby. You're right to be suspicious. I shagged her.
What?
I shagged her rotten, baby, yeah.
I don't believe you, Austin. But she was repellent.
Saucer of milk table, too.
Well. What, did you use protection?
Of course. I have a 9mm automatic.
I'm shag mad, baby.
You know, there's nothing I like better than birds. I'm a certified bird watcher. I should open up a pet store specializing in... well, birds. Here are my fab birds of the 90s. Of course, the most fab bird of the 90s is obviously my co-star, Elizabeth Hurley. But we'll be seeing much more of her later on. Now let's check out some other fine specimens. My first fab bird of the 90s is Jenny McCarthy. You know, I've had a unique experience, men. I've actually seen Jenny McCarthy naked. Now that's not something any loser with 595 can do.
Hey.
Our next bird hails from south of the border. Her name is Selma Hayek. I'd love to perform the Hayek maneuver on her. Near the top of my list is Halle Berry. I'd like to shag her in a barn on the Sabbath and make a strawberry sundae. You see, straw would be in the barn and berry is her last name and the Sabbath is Sunday, so strawberry sundae. Sorry. You know, the 90s have seen momentous events like the fall of the Berlin Wall, but to me, the most important historical moment in the 90s has to be September 15th, 1990, the day Baywatch first premiered. Gaw blimey, I almost ruptured my undercarriage when they came on the telly.
Yeah, that makes me horny.
Next up is a lovely lady I saw on the telly, RuPaul. She's so strong and yet so ladylike. I'd love to shag that African queen, baby, yeah. Tucked in. Or not, you know, moving on. My next fab bird of the 90s is Courtney Cox. With a name like that, who needs friends?
Oh, behave.
Then there's Liv Tyler. She's unbelievable. Where'd she get those full, luscious lips? Must have been from her mother. Finally, we come to the Spice Girls. They're English, they wear tight clothes, and they have good teeth. What more could you ask for? Let's take a look at their new video. Say you'll be there. Oh, I'll be there, all right. If there's some shagging involved. Yeah, baby!
Austin, who do you think is sexier, cumin or parsley?
I like Old Spice, baby. Yeah!
Personally, I prefer parsley.
I like cumin.
What do you get if you cross England?
What do you get when you cross England's hottest girl group?
What do you get when you cross latest England? Hey.
With five Wonder Bras. I don't know what the hell is that. I
beep.
Fit up.
What do you get when you cross latest girls group with winter?
What do you get?
A hammer?
Austin, who do you think is sexier, cumin or parsley?
No, I use my finger. Hang on just a tick, because when the Austin Powers psychedelic swinging shindig returns, we'll have a tribute to the Groovalicious Elizabeth Hurley.
Stay right there, swinger. Austin will be right back. By the way, does my voice make you horny? Does it? I think it makes you horny. Yeah, baby.
Horticulture. Horticulture.
Signs of planting.
Nurse Judy on duty.
Care to have a little fun?
No, actually, I have to save the world.
Is it cold in here?
Check out this video by Space. It's called Female of the Species. Yeah, baby. Woo!
I'd like to point out that more deadlier is actually improper grammar. Thank you.
Shock, shock, horror, horror, shock, shock, horror. I'll shout myself hoarse for your supernatural force. The female of the species is more.
The key to picking up chicks, of course, is to be yourself, especially if you're handsome and rich and powerful. But don't worry if you're a bit of a square. Here are a few fab pickup lines you can learn. Hello, baby, would you like to see my jumbo jet? You want to shag me.
You want to shag me.
No, 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 no. You want to shag me.
No, 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 no. You want to shag me.
All right, hold on a tick. That's not right. In my homeland, I'm considered quite handsome. No, 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 no. You want to shag me.
No, 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 no. You want to shag me.
Horticulture.
Well, I'm half Russian and a little bit of German.
Do you have a little English in you?
No.
Would you like some? Listen, do you want a shag or don't you?
How many swingers does it take to screw in a light bulb?
Let's see. 14?
Who writes this stuff? Well, chaps and chapettes, I've got a treat for you now. Would you like to know what it is?
Yeah.
Would you?
Yeah.
All right. It's my tribute to Elizabeth Hurley. Elizabeth is one groovy bird, man. Look up shagadelic in the dictionary, and there's a picture of her. She's so switched on, she glows in the dark, baby. She's my partner in Austin Powers, International Man of Mystery. She's an internationally known supermodel, and she's not a half-bad cricket player either. I ask you, what more can a man ask for? It's like I entered Groovy Bird into one of those newfangled electronic computers, and out she came. Check out this clip, baby.
Austin?
Yes?
Come and have some champagne with me.
Okay. Oh, I tripped. Oh.
You know, I haven't had this much fun since college.
Well, I'm sorry.
Why?
I'm sorry that bug up your ass had to die.
Always wanting to have fun, Austin. That's you in a nutshell.
No, this is me in a nutshell. Help! I'm in a nutshell! How did I get into this nutshell?
Now, in the film, there's a certain romantic spark between Miss Hurley and me.
I will never have sex with you, ever.
You know, sort of an animal attraction, man.
If you were the last man on Earth and I was the last woman on Earth.
A friction. A hormonal train wreck, baby.
And the future of the human race depends on our having sex simply for procreation. I still would not have sex with you.
What's your point, Vanessa?
I would just like everyone to know that what you see on the screen is acting and nothing more. Our relationship was strictly platonic, and I totally respect Miss Hurley's professionalism.
No.
Be sure to come and see Elizabeth Hurley in our new movie, Austin Powers, International Man of Mystery. It all takes place in a hot tub, and both of us are basically naked throughout the entire film.
Mix in 1 pound meatloaf, 2 smashing pumpkins,
3 red hot chili peppers, and a dash of Veruca salt. Throw in 3 hot chili peppers and a dash of Veruca salt.
Whatever that is.
And 1 sliced melon. What did I screw up?
3 red hot chili peppers, right?
Veruca salt.
A sliced blind melon.
Dash of Veruca salt.
some cranberries and one slice of blind melon.
And what do you get?
Next year's Lollapalooza? 14?
There's more grooving to come. When we come back, I'm going to get buck naked and dip myself in a giant vat of milk chocolate. Well, not really, baby. But I think that made you horny. Did it? Did that make you horny, baby? Yeah.
Krakatoa.
He has touched our hearts and warmed our souls.
What a... Yes! Look, I'm sorry, but if I didn't do this, they said they'd cut me out of the movie.
Thank you.
Oh, Austin, I'd like you to meet somebody. This is my mother, Mrs. Exposition.
Lovely.
Austin!
What have you done?
That's not your mother, it's a man, baby!
No.
Why won't this wig come off?
You know, the first thing I did after I was unfrozen was watch MTV for 24 straight hours. I mean, what a great idea. Gorgeous birds set to music, man, it's brilliant. Of course, if I had a channel on the telly, I'd go one step further. I'd call it the Shag Network. Thursday nights, I'd have Must Shag TV with Third Shag from the Sun, or Suddenly Susan is Shagging, and of course, Shagfeld at 9 o'clock. One night I'd have serious dramas like NYPD Shag and the Shag Files. Creepy, man. I could even have game shows. Wheel of Shag. Sports shows. Wide World of Shag. My motto would be, all shagging, all the time, baby. Yeah!
Don't throw a trombone.
Juicy navel, orange juice.
Do you want to be like dirty, dirty?
Oranges. Oh, oranges? Shuck.
Check out this next video, baby. Magic Piper of Love by Edwin Collins. Yeah, man.
I'm through with love hangovers. It's best that I stay sober. No rolling in the clover. No Gretna Green to Dover. No honeymoon. Sniper, the magic piper of love, the magic piper of love, of love. That I'd want to be is sat upon his Christmas tree or playing his games of catch as catch can. Cause he's a sweet talker, a silent stalker, all the savvy of a street walker, more deadly than a horned piper, the magic piper. Of love.
that's all the time we have, baby. Thank you for partying with us. You've been a very groovy audience. Don't miss my movie, Austin Powers International Man of Mystery, shagging at a theater near you on May 2nd. Yeah, baby! Hey, look, the Swedish girls have arrived, baby. Now we can really start the party.
We have colored in here like a red lamb.
Ham is so smooth.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Surrender, if you please.